Hey everybody, welcome back to Run and Gun. I'm JT, and if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. That really helps support the channel, and make sure to give me a like if you like this video. Also, let me know down below in the comments if you enjoyed my vintage film camera review. I want to do a lot more of these in the future, and if it's something you enjoy, definitely let me know, and let me know what kind of old film cameras you have. So moving on, let's talk about this Kodak Pony 4 camera. This thing is really awesome, and this video is going to be a little bit different. It's going to be kind of B-roll heavy, so you have something to look at instead of my face the entire time. So I'm playing with this camera while recording this, and you guys get to watch pretty pictures of the camera. So the one thing I absolutely love about old school film cameras is the tactile functions and the clicking and the snapping and just everything, especially if the camera's in pristine condition. You can hear these very nice clicks, and that's my film winding knob, and then I have my aperture ring right around the front of my lens, and I also have a shutter speed ring that has some nice clicks to it, and then actually cocking for my exposure, and then the sound of the shutter itself. It's just super clean and super crisp, and I absolutely love this camera. I love taking it apart. I love making sure that it's clean, getting all the dust out of there, and loading films of blast in this too, which I'm not gonna do in this video. I'm gonna save that for my next video. But all you have to do to load film in this, there's a little silver sidebar, and there's a little indentation knob where you push in, slide the sidebar down, and then the entire back of the camera just completely lifts off. And then what is a total pain is to get this thing back in here. So I line up the left side over here and then swing the back around, make sure I'm putting pressure on the back, and then I slide the silver bar up again until it clicks. There we go. So again, this camera is a blast just to play with. I haven't even shot a roll of film on it, and I love it so far. I love the build quality. It's 2020 right now, which means this camera is already 63 years old, and it still works, which is amazing, which means the build quality back then was awesome. I would not expect a camera from today to last 63 years. Now, the lens on this guy is a fixed lens. It's a Kodak Anistar lens, 44mm f3.5, and I have all sorts of these little labels on the top. The top says lens opening number, and it goes 9 through 4, possibly 4.5. And then I also have shutter number labels that go 8 through 5. And the reason there are these arbitrary numbers is because there's a little cheat sheet on the back. And what you do to get exposure, if you don't know what shutter speed is and you don't know what your aperture is, if you have a fixed ISO, which is always the case if you're shooting film, what you do is you just add these arbitrary numbers up. And so if I were to add up, let's say 7 and 5, that adds up to 12 on my lens opening number and my shutter number, I would look on the back and see what condition a 12 would be good for shooting. And in this case, that would be in bright sun, sand, and snow. And if I wanted to shoot in the shade, I see 8.5 here on the back, so I'm gonna turn this to 8.5. So I'm gonna open my lens up to 3.5, and I'm going to close my shutter down, it's kind of interesting here. I'm not used to having, you know, a shutter ring on my lens. That's very strange to me. So that it works when I cock my little shutter lever here on the side, that's what kind of resets my shutter for me, and then I hit that shutter button on top. Now, what I really love is that Kodak put the corresponding aperture values and the shutter speeds on the bottom. So if you do know what you're doing and you do understand the basics of exposure, I can see here on the bottom, I have a bulb mode. I have 30th of a second, a 60th, a 125th, and 250th of a second for my shutter speeds. And then for my aperture, I have values of 3.5, 4, 5.6, 8, 11, 16. And then I can close all the way down to f22. And again, very nice, clean, tactile click. Somebody really took pretty good care of this Kodak camera. I really love the mix of the black and the matte silver gray, and then the shiny chrome on the lens and the different knobs, and the rewind knobs are nice and shiny. And this guy is still a little bit dusty from when I picked him up at the thrift shop down in Texas. I picked up quite a few cameras, but I got this little Kodak Pony for about, I think, 10 or 20 bucks, and absolutely worth it. I cannot wait to shoot with this camera. And what I think I'm gonna do for my first roll of film, Sweet Lou Photography and I have been trying to collaborate on another video, so I'm thinking about shooting a roll of film in this and then shipping it out to him across the country in New York, and then having him reshoot on it and do a whole roll of double exposures from two different photographers. And I've never seen that done before. Again, you guys are hearing about this the same time he is, so I'm curious to see his reaction to that in the comments, but I think that would be a lot of fun to test out this camera. And the day after I got this camera, I was actually doing some Google searching, and I found the original manual that someone scanned in. It's awesome. It's labeled Kodak Pony Camera from Eastman Kodak in Rochester, New York. It tells you everything you need to know about the shutter release, the winding knobs, how to keep this thing clean, the different accessories. This was so clearly designed in the 1950s. I'll show some screenshots from this, but I love the typeface. I love the little graphic illustrations. It really explains everything so well. There's a page called Fumbles, which gives you some different scenarios of images and what you might be doing, like if you're obscuring your lens, because in this particular camera you have a viewfinder which is separate from your lens, so you're not looking through your viewfinder, which is why in old photos you would see a lot of times people would put their finger in front of the lens on accident, because you can see through your viewfinder just fine, but you're not seeing what's actually in front of your lens, which is about probably an inch or so away from your viewfinder. So I cannot wait to shoot on this camera. I hope you guys enjoyed some of the B-roll of this thing. It just looks like it's straight out of the 50s, and I really enjoy that. So this was kind of my first initial impressions with the Kodak Pony 4 camera. If you guys find one of these, I'd absolutely recommend picking it up. I think I got super lucky that the shutter and everything in this still works, and the shutter in my Brownies that I picked up still work, and my Polaroid Sun 600 that I also found thrift shopping still works as well. If you like this video, make sure you hit thumbs up. Let me know down below in the comments what kind of older film cameras that you have. Some people collect them. I'm actually starting to collect older film cameras. I'm actually looking for a Mamiya 645. That is a 6 by 4.5 inch medium format camera, if I'm not mistaken. And I'd really like one of those for portraits. So if you guys get any leads on one, let me know. But that is all for this video. Make sure you hit that like button. And until next weekend, get out and go shoot.